I'm Deb Miller. My daughter is Anya Miller, and she is a senior. This is our seventh year at Linden Hall. We came to Linden Hall from the local public school, which was really a great experience for all four of my kids, but we felt like she needed a much more challenging curriculum to just become a better student. So in her school district, she was in the Spanish immersion program from kindergarten through fifth grade, so most of her education was in Spanish. So when she came here, she was fluent in Spanish already and, you know, took Spanish with Senora, took AP at, I want to say ninth grade maybe. But we felt she needed a bigger academic challenge. And coming from a huge public school to a small school like this, each girl, I think, is really given a voice. Whereas you're not one of 2,000 students or not one of 500 in your class. Each girl, I know we say, is valued and known, and I think that is really true about Linden Hall. Every teacher knows your name. Students greet me by my name. You know, when you're involved, you get to know the other girls, and it becomes a community of students being nurtured by educators, and it's something I think very special that you don't get in public school because just the sheer number of students. I had the privilege of living on the other side of the school, so I come in the back entrance, and the first thing I see every time is Girls Rule, and I love it because this is a community of educators and nurturers and parents and students. It's all about uplifting our girls, giving them a voice, preparing them to go out into the world that in some ways is male dominant. I think we all know that. But having them be confident in their abilities, in their ability to speak, in their ability to lead, that I think is very unique to this school. When there's 2,000 students or 500 in a class, the athletes shine. You know, I think those good students or average students kind of get lost because of sheer volume, number of students. So here, when you have 60 in a class or 40 in a class or 20 in a class, you can't hide. You know, everyone is valued and everyone is known. And after 7 years, I truly believe that to be true. It's not just something we throw out there that this is what we believe. I really believe this is what we do. I will be honest, as a parent, I looked for ways to have her meet boys. And actually, athletics is probably the biggest way right now. You know, when she plays her AAU travel or she goes to Spooky Nook to practice, that's where she meets guys mainly. She's not as interested in the dances because it's more of like, okay, talk. You know, that's kind of odd. But she has always been comfortable around guys. But I do look for opportunities to just have them around because I don't want her to go to college and feel awkward. We came here because we were really looking for a rigorous college preparatory program that would really challenge her and really prepare her. And one thing I really appreciate about Linden Hall is, you know, if there's a course you want to take that is not being offered, and I'm going to throw journalism out there. She talked to Ms. Teske, her advisor, who is also an academic dean, and we had that class this year. In public school, you would never get that, you know, and we're happy to have a class for 3 or 4 or 5 girls. You know, we don't say we need 20 to offer a new class, but if there's an interest, I know they will do everything they can to make it happen. And I think that's very unique with our school, that we are willing to listen to girls' voices, their interests, and see how can we make our girls and our school better. You know, in public school, I think there's so many girls that friendships kind of come and go. Whereas in a smaller school, you're kind of like a family. I know we use the word sisterhood, but we really are. So I would say her good friends today were probably her good friends back in sixth grade when she started. And even though some are dorm students and gone over the summer, I know they still communicate and they can't wait to see each other come, you know, August when everybody's back on campus. I was born and raised in Japan. My brother lives in Nepal. My sister lives in Japan. So this whole global education to me is really a big thing and another one of the reasons we chose to come here. I'll never forget in like sixth grade there was one of their classes, you know, she was learning about Muslims and different religions, and I don't know if we would have touched on that in public school, but it was a very exciting thing to learn from girls from different cultures that I think is unique to Linden Hall. And another interesting thing is my daughter's biracial. She never realized she was different in public school. she realized she was white and African-American here at Lyndon Hall. Interestingly, I would think it would be backwards, you know, in public school. But here, when she met strong women who were from Nigeria, who were from Kenya, who were from India, and realized that it was, they were different, and it was something that was worth celebrating, she really discovered herself here, which I still as a parent think is really interesting, because I thought she would have felt different in public school because it was primarily a white school. But she discovered how beautiful she is being biracial at this school because we have girls of every color. And that to me is really amazing. And I'm happy that she's leaving here feeling that way as she goes out into the world, that she is confident and loves herself for being who she is. I think that's a huge gift that Lyndon Hall has given her. One of the biggest things, and I talked about it today again, is the communication between faculty and staff and the parents. You know, and yes, we are a much smaller school, so it's probably easier for that to happen, but each girl is known and valued. I keep going back to that. Back in September of last year, at 6 o'clock on a Saturday night, she broke her leg playing basketball. By Sunday morning, Mike Waylett, head of school, had emailed us saying, "I heard Anya got hurt. How's she doing?" By Monday morning, 48 hours later, a little bit less, Beth Teske emailed and said, "So sorry to hear about Anya. What kind of special accommodations does she need?" I was blown away that over a weekend, when I had not told either of them, they somehow heard about this and reached out to us to show us that they just really cared about her. And I don't think it was because she's an elite athlete. I really don't. She's part of this family and she's part of this community who really cares about the girls. And I'll never forget that, because that was so touching to me, because I was so surprised that through the weekend, somehow that information had been shared and they reached out to us.